everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to do a collaboration with Equine Molly, so you will get to see her video tomorrow, and it will be out on her channel, which is linked down below, so take a look tomorrow. I am going to do 5 bad things about loaning a horse, and she's going to do 5 good things about loaning a horse. Small disclaimer before I start, this has nothing to do with my current situation loaning a horse, because loaning Atilla is absolutely a dream, and the owner doesn't really have any like major restrictions. So loaning Atilla has nothing to do with this video. This video is based on my own experience from previous loan horses and friends' experiences of loaning horses. So I just made that into this video about bad things about loaning a horse. So let's get started. One, knowing that the horse isn't really yours and you have to follow the owner's rules about what to do with a horse and like what tack to use on a horse. I know that some owners won't even let you use your own saddle pad on the horse, or even an ear bonnet on the horse, even though it's not tack that actually hurts the horse. They don't want you to use it. So yeah, and like following the owner's rules, like I've been loaning one horse where I had to notify the owner about every single little thing, like even bringing a friend to the barn. I had to notify the owner, even though the friend wasn't even riding the horse. I had to notify the owner, and even though the barn wasn't actually the owner's, I had to notify if I brought a friend to the barn. So yeah, just like small little things, that just knowing that this isn't your horse, but even so, like a saddle pad won't hurt a horse. Changing up stirrups and changing them back, like, isn't gonna hurt anything. So yeah, like, one, just knowing that it isn't your horse and you have to follow the owner's rules, either you agree or disagree. Because you know that if you disagree too much, then you're off the horse and you care about the horse. So yeah, that's one. Two is the space for tack. Usually at the barns where I've been to, there's just enough space for each stall and each horse to have one tack locker and one like saddle rack and bridle rack and stuff like that. It's just enough space for one horse in each locker and each space, so you can actually let your riding boots or your helmet or vest or anything stay at the barn. So you have to bring your riding equipment back and forth each and every time you ride. Either way, you are there about 2 or 3 times a week. You can't let your riding gear be there. You have to bring it back and forth, and sometimes that can be really exhausting, because if you forget your helmet, then yeah, whatever, I can't ride today, and stuff like that. So this amount of space should be a little bit bigger, so you can leave your things at the barn and not annoy the owner by having your stuff at the barn. Three is tack. Like, one of the things that I'm really concerned about is actually breaking tack. Not on, like, purpose, but if it happens, like if you're out on a hack and the reins snaps, and or you're out on a hack and the saddle scratches, or stirrups gets ruined, or stirrup leathers get ruined. I mean, even though it's not your fault, you're the one who's breaking it, because either it's in bad condition or it had been used for too long and needed to be changed anyway, and you're the one who breaks it, you feel like you have to buy the new tack. If it were your own horse, you would have duct taped whatever you could duct tape, but until you could afford getting new tack. But loaning horses and using the tack that's on the horse sometimes can be a real thrill. I'm lucky enough to that I can change out my stirrups because I can't use the normal stirrups. I have to have the flexi stirrups because of my joints. But now, like Atilla's owners, she actually do love those stirrups, so she rides in them as well, which is awesome. So yeah, having other people's tack is sometimes a bit of a thrill. Off-property. I mean, if you loan a horse, some of you might want to take the horse off-property, either go to shows with them or clinics or stuff like that, because you loan the horse, you want to learn with the horse. And I feel like some owners are really difficult on that one, like bringing the horse somewhere else. I'm lucky enough that I can go to another barn that is actually in walking distance, but I can go to another barn to take lessons. But I know that there are some owners that won't even let people go off property to take lessons with their loan horse. They can just do whatever the owner says to do, which is kind of sad because, yeah, you're loaning the horse, you do whatever you can to loan the horse, and you treat the horse like you own when you have it. But still, as I said in number one, mentioned in number one, you know it's not your horse. So the off-property things, everything that you need to do to get the horse off-property, and changing days, and notify the owner, and discuss with the owner to take the horse somewhere else for you to learn, can be sometimes very difficult. Number five, riding someone else's horse. Like, I'm very confident when I'm at the dressage trainings and when I'm in the arena, but loaning a horse, I sometimes get a little bit more terrified when I go on hacks, because everything that can happen on a hack, like bolting and yeah, everything like that, it's just, you're more on the alert. Like if the horse bolts and you fall off and the horse goes goodbye, it's like, okay, I need to get up to get that horse. If it were my horse, it would like, okay, there he goes, hope he finds the way home. But if it's another one's horse, you can go, okay, let's be out here for 2 hours looking for that horse, because it's not yours. And if the horse gets like a tiny bit of an injury on hacks and stuff, like a scratch or anything, some owners can be over dramatic about it and actually sort of blame you. And yeah, that was my five things. Bad things about loaning a horse. And as I said, this has nothing to do with my current situation with Atilla, because loaning Atilla and have the most chill owner is just the best ever. So I feel so relaxed having Atilla. Anyway, go and check out Equine Molly's video tomorrow. I will link her channel down below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell beside the subscribe button to get notified when I post my videos. Until then, bye!